Long before the railroad was laid into the Ozark Mountains of Arkansas, Indians and then a few daring pioneers had heard stories of mountain springs that produced waters with miraculous powers. It was said these springs were hidden deep in the forested valleys of western Arkansas. Some were said to be hard to find, but as word of the healing waters spread across our country, visitors began traveling to the Ozarks, coming any way they could, by wagon, on horseback, and they kept coming until by the late 1870s, a town was built around one of the miracle springs, and Eureka Springs was born. By the time the railroad was built into Eureka Springs in 1883, as many as 6 trains a day brought visitors here from New York and Chicago to the burgeoning town of 9,000, and they were all looking for help in the healing waters from nearby. Today, things have changed little in Eureka Springs. The wood-burning steam locomotive still chugs up and down the valley, its cars filled with tourists. But the train never leaves the valley these days. Tourists come here now by car, and they come for the charm of this town, not the water. They come for its Victorian turn-of-the-century style. The first of the famous springs that brought outsiders here back then was located right in the middle of town. Basin Springs still attracts vacationers, but long ago people stopped bathing in its waters. Today, it's a place where most everyone can take a break from the daily chores. That is, most everyone. Many of the town's homes and businesses are on the National Register of Historic Places, and they've been restored to reflect life in a bygone era. Spending a few hours in Eureka Springs can take you back a century or more. Just stepping into the lobby of the Bank of Eureka Springs brings back memories of days gone by, even down to the original candlestick telephones that still today work. Bank President John Cross is in the vanguard to keep Eureka Springs looking old.
We want to keep it quaint. We want to keep it, you know, old-fashioned, old-style, and everything we do is directed towards that end. We've deliberately kept industry out of here. I'm talking about smokestack industry. People want to boost the economy, and growth is not always progress, and we've recognized that, and we work towards that end.
When a town spends all that energy on restoring the past, it will just naturally attract artisans and artists who appreciate the best. Don Underwood's work can be found all around Eureka Springs, from the Ozark Corinthian columns set in the bank building itself to stonework all over the city. Don migrated from Colorado several years ago. Attracted by the architecture and the great stone nearby, he set up a workshop near town and today carves everything from delicate statues to railroad bridges. He has found that life here is hard to beat.
The people, there's a totally different type of people here. The people are very friendly. People are interested in being here. They're here for a reason. Everyone's here for a reason. They aren't here just for the job. The potential in restoration and the interest in architecture, historic preservation, all of these add up to the type of reasons everyone's here.
Susan Morrison is a well-respected artist who moved here 3 years ago. Currently working on a complicated collection of prints on Arkansas forest scenes, she has ambitious plans that she feels could turn this town into an art center rival to New York and Paris. For her, it's the atmosphere here that cannot be equal.
It's magic. You know, what else can I say? There's something about the energy that is already here that makes us feel very comfortable. And it's a very safe feeling kind of a place. I think that's why we're here. And because we are here, we have these wonderful interchanges that can go on, and it's real important to us. We feed each other.
Susan Morrison, Don Underwood, and John Cross. Along with thousands of tourists each day, they agree that there is indeed something special, something magical about a little Victorian village tucked away in the Ozark Mountains. Eureka Springs, where they look back toward tomorrow. At least once in the life of every boy, at the moment he sees his first steam locomotive, a dream that could last a lifetime is born. He wants to be a railroad engineer.
Mind if I watch?
The Eureka Springs and North Arkansas Railroad is a restoration of the line that once brought tourists into the Ozark Mountains as far back as 1883. Running the oldest wood-burning locomotive still operating in this country, the six-mile line is the brainchild of Bob Dorch.
So we like the wood. It was old and the original fuel that locomotives used in the very beginning of railroads. And, of course, it was old and simple. The later locomotives are larger and more complicated, so we like it just like it is.
Board!
About 2 or 3 years old, my mother and father took me down to Union Station in Little Rock, sat me up on the midway there, and I watched the steam locomotives go by, and I just fell in love with railroads. Got a lot of railroad people in my family, and grandfather worked for Missouri Pacific for about 45 years on steam locomotives, and I always dreamed of being able to do that. This is an opportunity I couldn't pass up.
Might as well say you're the captain of the ship. They go on my directions, the engineer or your brakeman take signals from me. They don't move or start or stop this train unless I say so.
Are you a lot of responsibility?
Yes, sir, very much so.
What's the fun part of running this railroad?
Actually, we're trying to bring back a little bit of yesterday today, and I think everybody likes a little bit of nostalgia, and that's exactly what we're trying to do. We think we're going to have one of the best railroads in this state. In fact, we know we're going to have the best short line there is.
You're in the railroad business. Is there some romance to these steam engines? Tell me about your experiences with them.
Well, steam engines were very hard work. I mean, the romance of getting onto them now is great, but the maintenance of the engines was very hard. And hard work, so the romance of it was actually trying to get them out and riding them after they're proud.
What do I think about it?
I love it.
I think it ought to have more like it, especially wood burners. Because all I've ever seen is steam engines, and I like to see wood.
Eureka Springs and North Arkansas Railroad, where at least for a few minutes, a young man's dream can come true.